Hi guys, it's Rachel, program specialist at the Northern Senior Activity Center. Since we're all enjoying the comforts of our home, I figured it would be a great time to introduce to you some DIY crafts that you can do with things around your house. So the first thing that we're going to be making today is we're going to be making a DIY mason jar herb hanger. And for this craft, you're going to need the following. You're gonna need 4 mason jars. These are pint-sized mason jars. They can be any color. If you choose to use wide mouth, that's what I'm using here. That's ideal so that your plant has a lot of space to grow and has a lot of surface area for watering. But whatever you have available is fine. You're going to need some hose clamps. These are stainless steel hose clamps. They are 1.5 through 3.5 inch diameter hose clamps. You can get these at Tractor Supply, or you may very well have these around if you used them for any kind of plumbing work. You're going to need a piece of wood. Ta-da! So we are currently building planter boxes to have a garden. And so we've got lots of pallet wood. This is actually really thick pallet wood. So I figured I liked this piece. It was just kind of laying around. It had some character to it. I liked the holes. I liked that it had some life to it. So we're gonna be using this guy. And I'm gonna be honest with you. I thought I could do this craft with nails, but I have a feeling that I'm gonna need to break out the big guns because this is some really thick wood. If you had a thinner wood, you could probably use some nails, but because this is really thick, I'm using power tools. Da, da, da. So I'm gonna be using a drill and I'm going to be using some screws. As long as any screw will do as far as, you know, what you have available to you. I think these are decking screws, so this might be a little bit of overkill. This might be like really like industrial for this purpose, but that's okay. That's the whole point. We want to be using stuff that we have so that we can have fun and we can try making cool new stuff. So I am going to be turning the camera down so you can see what I'm doing. I will give you a quick heads up that I did sort of eyeball measure the board. I didn't have like a measuring tape or anything like that. I really didn't want it to get that technical. So I just sort of eyeballed where I wanted the jars to go by laying them out. And I took this little attachment here. I don't know how many of you are familiar with using power tools, but ladies, if you're not familiar with using power tools, you got to start working on that stuff. Empower yourself with power tools. I use this little guy to sort of get me started, just pre-drilling some holes into the wood so that it's easier when I go to drill the screw in. I didn't want it to start spinning and shoot off somewhere because that would just be no fun. So I'm going to go ahead and turn the camera down and we're going to get started. So here we go. Whee! I got to turn this up so you can see. Can you see me? I see you. All right. Hey, look, it's a board of wood. So the first thing we're gonna do is, I don't know if you can see, but I have my little pre-drilled holes. They're really, really, really small compared to the honking nails that were in this bad boy. Now, I'm gonna show you preference. So, I'm a big fan of the knot in the front. So, when you use these, I don't know if you've ever used them before, but you twist this and it loosens or tightens the hose clamp so that you can take the jar in and out. But I like the look of the hose clamp in the front. So I went ahead and lined him up and counted. And it's about at the 10th rung, starting back here, 10 in. That's about where I want to put it in here, just so that the hose clamp can be in the front. But if that's not a preference for you, if you don't really care where the hose clamp ends up, or if you want the hose clamp to be on the side, then by all means go into the last indent. But that's what I would like to do. So that's what I'm going to get started doing. So I've got my hose clamp. This guy is the one where I tried to nail and it did not work out to my advantage. But I'm gonna slide my wood down so we can see what's going on. And we're gonna get started. So I'm gonna count in. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right. So we're gonna get this guy all lined up. Line up, everybody, line up. Make sure he's straight. Drill in. And I'm gonna pick him up a little bit. we go.
Woo! That was really tough.
I gotta make sure he's tighter. Let me lock him in.
All right.
So, we are officially in. And I can show you what that looks like. Put your jar in like so. Twist them up. Go. And he is in. One down. Three to go.
Stop me on the corner. Swear you hit me like a vision. I wasn't expecting. But who am I to tell fate where it's supposed to go with it? Don't you blink, you might miss it. See, we got a right to just love it or leave it. You find it and keep it, cause it ain't every day you get the chance to say, oh, this is how it starts. Lightning strikes the heart. It goes off like a gun, brighter than the sun. Oh, we could be the stars falling from the sky.
So, and there you have it, friends. We have our planters in place. Let me spin it around for you so you can see. We got all of our jars. And now we're gonna fill it up. So, like I said before, you can keep these and use them for, you can use them for all different kinds of stuff. If you want to, you can use it as decor in your house. You could put like cotton swabs or, can you see what I'm doing? You could put cotton swabs, you could put cotton balls in there, you could use it to store your toothbrush and have it in your bathroom kind of a thing, or you could put little flameless candles in there. This would also be a really great project to do if you are interested in just displaying something that you've canned, like green beans or any of that kind of stuff. Just sort of have that handy. But yeah, so we're gonna open these up. And then I have all four of these guys over here. I've got some plants I'm gonna put in them. So, I have some cilantro. I have some dill. I have some lemon, lemon thyme. Scooch these over so you can see. And I have some Mexican tarragon. So I am going to plant these guys and I will be right back. Hey guys, I'm back. So like I said, you just gotta drill them in. Sometimes it takes a little bit more muscle than others, especially if you've got a thick wood. My advice, if you can find some smaller screws, great. You don't want it to be poking out the back, but you just want to make sure you can get them in. Sorry, I've got dirt. I've been playing with plants, but I just wanted to let you know that they're all set up and ta-da! There are plants on a board of wood. They're super cute. You can bolt this into the wall. It actually stands up nicely if you want to just have it sort of as a back panel, even on the table up against the wall. It's really cute if you don't want to have to screw it in. But it's a really nice complement to any space, really great for your kitchen. And like I said, you don't have plants, but you want to get involved in a craft like this, you can use this to help spruce up a bathroom space, filling it with all sorts of other toiletry items. But yeah. That is my DIY craft for the day. I hope you guys have fun. I hope you enjoy making it, and I hope it brings a little bit of rustic charm to your home. And I will see you again in the next crafting video. Take care, everybody. Bye.